Hey there, Cybersecurity here. Previously, we learned how digital signatures prove authenticity without sharing a secret key, unlike HMACs. We also saw a big problem. How can we be sure that we are using the correct public key in the first place? What if Joker sneaks in his public key and pretends to be Sam? Today, let's uncover the solution, digital certificates. Let's roll.
Man in the middle attack. You and Sam want to chat securely. But how? Here's the plan. Step 1. Use asymmetric encryption, public and private keys, to safely share a symmetric key. Step 2. Use that symmetric key to encrypt your actual messages. Simple, right? But there's a huge problem. Let's break it down. You send Sam your public key. Sam sends you his public key. You use Sam's public key to lock a symmetric key, a secret code, and send it to him. Sam unlocks it with his private key. Now you both have the same secret code to encrypt messages. Easy.
And we have learned in previous lessons that symmetric keys are faster for longer chats. But to share them securely, we do need those public keys.
But here's the catch. What if Joker swaps those public keys? Is there a possible attack? Yes, man in the middle, or in our case, Joker in the middle.
Before we get there, let's lay some groundwork. On the internet, how do you think your phone or your computer exchanges public keys?
With all the web services that you use, example Google, Instagram, even WhatsApp, there are intermediate servers through which your data travels to the destination servers, right? So the man in the middle in this attack represents the bad server along the way. So if on the internet, you're having conversation with your friend, and let's say you're talking to your friend through WhatsApp, then your messages are first going to whatsapp.com and then to your friend. So the man in the middle refers to the bad servers along the way, which forward your messages to the destination server, in this case, WhatsApp. So in our example, Joker will represent that bad server along the way. Sam will represent WhatsApp.com. So let's see the real attack. While you and Sam were exchanging public keys, there was Joker through which all conversations were passing through. So therefore, when you guys were exchanging public keys, Joker kept your public key to himself, gave a fake public key to Sam, telling him that it's your public key, and vice versa. Just like this. Now, whatever messages you send to Sam, Joker decrypts those messages with his own private key. Because remember, to maintain confidentiality, you had encrypted those messages with Sam's public key. But since the key that you are encrypting with is actually Joker's public key, so he is easily able to decrypt those messages with his own private key. Then he reads the messages, maybe even changes them, and then locks the message with Sam's real public key. Then Sam opens the message with his own private key.
Neither of you notices, it's a classic man-in-the-middle attack. Confidentiality, integrity, authenticity are all broken at the highest level. So in real life, this could mean if a bad server is able to impersonate a legit server, say bank.com, you will be passing all your info, including your credit card details, your passwords, to the bad server without even realizing it. You will think that you're talking to bank.com because you have its public key. But that key itself is fake. So locking any messages with that key is worse than sending messages in plain text because you're duped into thinking that your messages with bank.com are secure, giving you a false sense of security. Scary, isn't it? So how do we make sure that we are using Sam's real public key and not Joker's fake one? This is exactly where digital certificates come in.
Digital certificate is like a cryptographic ID card for a public key signed by trusted authorities. Remember how your government ID has your photo, your name, and is stamped by the government office to certify that it's legit? A digital certificate is kind of like that, but for a public key. It's a proof that the public key that you're about to use actually belongs to Sam, or WhatsApp, your bank, and not the Joker in the middle. So what all does a digital certificate consist of? Public key, the actual key belonging to the server. Owner info, it states who it belongs to, like bank.com or whatsapp.com. Issuer info. This is the certificate authority or the CA who verifies and signs that the public key truly belongs to the domain in question. Think of CA as a trusted notary or a government office that issues official IDs. Digital signature by the CA. A cryptographic seal created using CA's private key, which you verify with the CA's public key, already trusted on your device, proving that the certificate and its public key are genuine and are untampered. We have done a whole video on digital signatures, go check that out. This signature ensures that nobody can tamper with the certificate details without getting caught.
So why do we need CAs at all? When we had to exchange public keys over the internet, the problem of man-in-the-middle attacks, fake public keys, was a really hard one to solve. So the whole internet decided to collectively trust in some organizations, saying whichever public keys will be signed by these orgs will know for sure that those public keys are legit. And since CA itself is a trusted org, clients like us could stress-free accept those public keys because CA said so. Before signing the certificate, a CA usually gives some test to the domain owner to prove that they actually own that domain. So guess what? If a joker tries to issue himself a fake certificate of, let's say, bank.com, the CA will never actually sign it because joker will fail those tests because joker does not own bank.com.
So if a joker still tries to give you a fake certificate without a CA signature, your browser or phone instantly yells danger with those scary security warnings. That's because your device doesn't trust random unsigned certificates. Conclusion: without a CA signed certificate, you have no trusted proof that the public key is the real deal. The chain of trust. Root CAs. Your device comes preloaded with a list of public keys from trusted certificate authorities like DigiCert, Global Sign, Let's Encrypt and others. The important point is that you don't have to download these CA public keys over the internet every time. They come baked into your device's trust store, making it extraordinarily difficult for attackers to tamper with them. Intermediate CAs. These root authorities often delegate signing to intermediate CAs. They have their own certificates signed by the root CA. Server certificates. Finally, your website or service gets its own certificate signed by one of these intermediate CAs. It's like a family tree of trust. Your device trusts the root CA. The root CA trusts the intermediate CA. The intermediate CA trusts the server certificate.
So when your device sees this signature chain, it happily says, "All right, I believe this site is who it claims to be."
So when you connect to WhatsApp.com, your browser automatically asks for WhatsApp's digital certificate. WhatsApp server sends back something like, "Here's my certificate signed by CAX, and here's CAX's certificate signed by root CAY. Your device ensures that the search chain is complete. That is, does the search chain end at the trusted root CA? Then it validates root CA's signature on the intermediate CA cert. Then it checks, is the intermediate CA's signature on the server certificate valid? Is the certificate unexpired? Does the domain name matches WhatsApp.com, etc.? So if everything looks good, the browser accepts the certificate and uses that public key inside it to safely exchange symmetric keys. If even a single step in this verification fails, the browser throws back a scary warning that the certificate is untrusted. Now let's open https://www.google.com in Firefox and check its actual certificate details. Look at the lock icon on the left side of the address bar. Click on it and select Connection Secure. Next, click on More Information. Here you can click on View Certificate and you'll see lines like Subject Google.com, Issuer GDSWR2, Validity, the start and end dates for when this certificate is valid. Now to really drive home how certificate chains work, Firefox will also show you something like this. GTSWR2, the intermediate CA certificate. GTS root R1, the root CA certificate, which your device trusts by default. This screenshot is from Keychain's certificate store, which you can also go and check in your keychain, GTS root R1 cert must be already there. If you want to go one step further and see the actual signature, go to the miscellaneous tab on the certificate viewer on Firefox. Once you have saved the certificate file, you can open up the terminal and run this OpenSSL command. This command will show you all the details, the subject, the issuer, even the public key and the actual signature. So how does this stop the Joker? Joker tries to give your browser a bogus public key. But your browser says, where's the certificate for that public key and who signed it? Joker can't produce a valid CA signature for the domain in question because the real CA won't sign his fake request. So if he does produce a forged signature, your browser or phone quickly sees it's invalid and throws an error. Result, no more successful man-in-the-middle attacks because the fake public key cannot pass a certificate check.
Pretty cool, right? So guys, always pay attention to your browser's warnings. Never just click through when it says the certificate is untrusted or is invalid. You might be talking to a joker in the middle. But for now, just remember, digital certificates is equal to authenticity guaranteed. Stay secure, folks. May no joker come in between you and your peace of mind. Stay safe. See you all next time.